Hello, my senior friends. So, we are discussing phonemes and phonology. Actually, I should have started with phonology. But I delayed it by two lectures. Because first I thought that I should tell you what a phoneme is. Because phonology, as you can see, phonology deals with the phonemes. Understand? So, without my telling what phonemes is, then what you will think, what is this strange thing called phoneme? Now you know what is phoneme. The general meaning of phoneme is, it is the smallest sound unit of a language, particular language, that is language specific, we say, and also its function is to show difference between utterances or words, isn't it? And they are, all the phonemes are in contrastive relationship, we say, that's what we say, one opposes the other. Suppose everything is similar, then you cannot, the communication will never take place, understand, that's the reason. So here, the simple definition is H.A. Gleason. These are all these people. H.A. Gleason, John Lyons, Ferdinand de Saussure, very famous, you know, Ferdinand de Saussure. Then Peter Landfoss and John D. Grinder and Susan Elgin. So all authorities in phonology and phonetics. So to quote them definitely will enrich your language and also your presentation if you are presenting, making a presentation of these things anywhere. Okay, let's begin. Almost you can see all the five definitions, isn't it? For the five definitions, they have something common. Like for example, the phonemes, deals with phonemes, arrangement of phonemes, organization of phonemes, selection of phonemes, and so on. So here the first one is H.A. Gleason. Simple definition for you to learn. Phonology deals with the phonemes and sequence of phonemes. Sequence, that's very important. For example, certain sequences are not allowed in a language. English has 44 phonemes. But you see, PL sequence is very common. I mean, it's allowed in English. P, see, for in this case, like P and L is allowed. But NL is not allowed. Can you show any word that begins with NL? In the beginning. NL, at the end you may find, but not in the beginning. So the word initial positions, NL is not allowed, right? So word final position, TR is not allowed, TR is one of the examples I am giving, sequence. Sequence means one coming after the other. So NL is not allowed, NR is not allowed in the beginning. Word beginning, word initial, word middle and word final positions are there. These things we will see later. But as I am just telling you, what is meant by sequence of phonemes? One comes after the other. Word initial positions, the English won't allow NL or not TR, let's say NR. Yes. Sorry, TR is allowed. No. Try is allowed. NR, NL, NR, and so on is not allowed. PL is allowed. Just want to show you what the sequence is. Yes. So, second definition, John Lyons. Phonology then is the level at which the linguist describes the sound system of a particular language, that is language specific. Understand? What then is phonology? It is a linguist or anybody, you can also describe it. When you describe, you will become a linguist. Yes. So, that is, when the sound system of a language is explained, that is called phonology. Understand? Now, that is simple. Ferdinand de Saussure, famous. Very, very, very famous. But Ferdinand de Saussure was actually a very, we said, talented and a gifted teacher. He did not write any books. But what happened is his students attended his classes and they compiled his notes to a book. So what good relationship he had with his students, isn't it? It's a gift, you know. If you have got good relationship with your students, then it is a gift by God. Yes, a phonological system is a description of the sounds with which a language functions. So the phonological system of English has got 44 sounds. And English functions with 44 sounds. As we have seen, 12 pure vowels, 8 diphthongs and 24 consonants, functions. For each language operates on a fixed number of well-differentiated phenomena. The well-differentiated. One is different from the other. So all languages in the world function like this. On the basis of what we said, each language operates in a fixed number of. English has 44. Then many other languages have fixed numbers. They cannot add or delete. It's a closed group, we say. Closed group. You cannot add or delete. For example, articles in English is a closed group. A and the. We don't have a fourth article. That is called a closed group means. Understand? And same with the, you can say pronouns in English. It's a closed group. You cannot admit another person into that group. Understand? It's exclusive. Yes. So like that, every language operates on a fixed number of well-differentiated phenomena. So they have every language has a platform, and that platform is the sounds. And the interesting thing about this is they are all different. Understand? So he is the professor who made that path-breaking announcement that in language there is no content, no reality, but only difference. Language, cat is cat because it is not dog. Dog is dog because it is not a peacock. Understand? When I say D-O-G dog, you don't find dog there. You find only a set of phonemes. See, that's the thing. Okay, very good. Then Peter Lightfoot, I have quoted him elsewhere. The description of the systems and patterns of sounds. Systems of sounds, like vowels, groups, classes. Vowels, diphthongs, consonants. Patterns, means this is a pattern. PL, NR, NL, PLI. Understand? ML is not allowed in English. That sequence is not ML. Initial word, initial position is not allowed. Right. So you have got that. Language is patterns of the sounds that occur in a language, that occur in a language. Again, language specific is a very important word. But sound should belong to a particular language, only then we can call them phonemes. As I already given you at the beginning, we are all human beings. We are not citizens. But when you belong to a particular country, we are citizens. Like that, sounds there are many in this world. Speech sounds. Many languages have many different types and classes of speech sounds. But when they are taken by a language, then it becomes a phoneme. Like English, yes. I think now it is clear to you again. Okay, occurring in a language is the phonology of the language. It is a set of rules that describe the changes in the underlying sounds when they occur in speech. See, we always speak about p, okay. But when you speak, you know, speech, this p changes. For example, p in pin, p in capital, and p in top. See the difference. So pop, there is, what does it describe? The changes in the underlying sound. This is the underlying sound. That is the basic sound. Basic p. More of this we will see. But p. And what happens is that when you use it in pin, capital, see that the p, the p sound in pin and the p sound in capital and the p sound in drop, all the three are different. Then the changes. When you in actual speech situation, in a speech event, the sounds undergo changes. You got that point. That is what he says. So it's what we must say, something deep. He goes a bit deep in that sense. Yes. Set of rules that describe the changes in the underlying sounds. Here the underlying sound is p, and it says when they occur in speech. In actual speech, see, I'll give an example. See, a teacher is a basic human being. When he stands in the class as a teacher, he undergoes changes. Not basic changes, but his manner, his gestures, his dress code, you know, changes. So, but the underlying thing is that person himself. Same thing when he is in the market, buying fish, changes take place in him. When he is in the church or temple, changes take place. So according to where you are present, what you are doing depends, the underlying person will change. The basic person is the same. Your name does not change. Your body does not change. Your muscles do not change. Your blood circulation remains the same. But you change the behavior. Like that here, for example, is a... Other example, I will tell you, I will give you a feel and girl. See, the L changes. So the sound L, it changes in feel. Feel. Ill. But girl. We don't say girl. You are a girl, we will not say no. Like girl. So when you are using that in speech, the underlying sound system, the underlying sounds, they undergo changes. That is what he says. He says, the description of the systems and patterns of life. System, the whole thing. Pattern, the sequences that occur in a language is the phonology of that language. It is a set of rules that describe the changes in the underlying sounds when they occur in speech. So in action, it undergoes changes. Think of a boy here, sitting here, you know, calm and quiet. When he is in the field, forward, he is jumping, then he changes, he undergoes changes. Right there, that's all. And here, the last definition. John D. Grinder and Susan Elvin says, it is the phonology of the language that tells us which sound sequences are acceptable. See here, I have already shown you this. NR is not acceptable at the word beginning, word initial position. NR is not acceptable. Then, NL is not acceptable. I'm just giving one of the examples. But PL is acceptable. So that way. So, it is the phonology of the language that tells us which sound sequences are acceptable as part of that language and which are not. And which accounts for the varying forms that these sequences may take in terms of sounds. That means the same thing. Varying sequences of sounds, varying the changes that a sound undergoes. Okay? It's not clear to you? Okay, once again, I will read and tell you what is it, explain to you what it is. That tells us phonology of the language. It is the phonology of the language. That tells us which sound sequences are acceptable as part of that language. That's okay. Which are the sound sequences that are acceptable is alright. That is very clear. And then he says, which accounts for varying forms. See the varying forms, pa and pin, pa and capital, pin, pa and top. Varying forms, yes. Varying forms that these sequences may take in terms of sounds. Well, variations take place to these sounds then when they are in a sequence. When they are in a sequence. In this sequence it is P. In this sequence it is cup. P. And it is top. Unreleased. It is not released. Alright. Is that clear to you how you taken this term? So now we can proceed properly. Properly, I should have started with phonology. I should have told you what is the definition of phonology. But I thought I will delay that a little because otherwise, I'll have to, lot of intervention will be required. No, it's very easy for you. The definitions have become very easy for you. It's clear, okay? So what is phonology and what is phoneme? So more of phonology will come now. Syllable, for example. What is a syllable? And also the theories about phonemes. For PhD students, is very important. Theories about phonemes are also important. There are the physical theory, there is Mendelistic theory, and so on. These things we will see tomorrow. I think that now it is clear for you what a phoneme is, what is phonology. So now we have stopped. We have covered the phonetics part of it. Now we have come to the phonological part of it. Phonology. Okay. Of linguistics. Yes. Now, and one more thing I would like to, yesterday I told you, But one more, once more I would like to tell you the difference between a phonetic symbol and a phonemic symbol. A phonetic symbol means a sound, that's all. A speech sound. It can belong to any language, like human being. You can belong to any place in this world, human being. But a phonemic symbol means you belong to, that sound belongs to a particular language. Like citizen means you belong to a particular country. Understand? You got that point? And they are in contrasting relationship and they are the smallest segments. Segments means parts of a language. Especially spoken language. It's not written language. Written language, you know, the smallest form is called letter, or you call it a pet name. That is grapheme. G-R-A, shall I write it here? G-R-A-P-H-E-M-E. Grapheme. Grapheme. Graph means to draw, isn't it? Draw or write, yes. See, graph, yes. So that is grapheme, means the smallest unit of the written language is grapheme. The smallest unit of the spoken language is phoneme, that's all. Okay, I think it's clear to you. If not, of course, you can ask me, I will explain this. Well, till then, bye. Have a nice day, enjoy.